Hi everyone, something different for today. My inspiration for today comes from a place that I love to visit that's close by to where I live, and that's Nan Tien Temple. It's a Buddhist temple and it's at Unanderra in New South Wales, Australia. And I thought that I would take some inspiration from the beautiful gardens there and the pond, which has lotus blossoms and koi. So I'm just going to have a play and we'll see where we go. First of all, I'm going to put down some yellows. These are Daniel Smith colours that I'm using. And it's a very smooth paper. It's very white. Really allows the watercolours to shine. So that colour was new gambage. Now I'm going to take some opera rose, thinking about the lotus blossoms. Just allowing these colours to mingle and mix. The next colour I'm going to take is from thinking about the water in the ponds. This is a little bit of ultramarine blue. This will obviously mix with the yellows and give me some greens. Just being very random, I'm actually not trying to paint anything at the moment, anything in particular. Just getting some colours down. The next colour I'm going to use is phthalo turquoise. So I'm using a number 10, excuse me, a number 10 squirrel brush. It's one of my favourite brushes to use. Tiny little bit of indigo. Just to give me a few darks, a bit of contrast. Okay, I need to let that dry. And then I'll come back to you soon. Okay, here I am back again. I've done a few sketches, just into some of the shapes. And you see a lotus blossom, a Buddha's face, and a few little koi. I just did that with a 2B pencil. And now I've got a micron Pigma pen. And that's an 03 in black. So it's fun to just doodle. Lose yourself in your drawing or your painting. So what I'll do, I'll show you a little bit of everything that I'm going to do, and then I will flip the camera and just speed up a little bit for you. So I'm just adding some of these markings to the koi. I also like to add some little bit of stippling for shading. So there's the koi. Just do this lotus blossom for you. You can see I'm not too worried about just keeping into the pink areas. A bit of shading at the base of these petals. Plus these back ones. Now we'll go on to the Buddha. to a lily pad. could, of course, excuse me, use a brush with a little bit of ink or a little bit of watercolour to fill this in. Could even use a bigger pen, like a Copic marker, to fill it in quickly. I hope this video inspires you to go away and do a little bit of doodling of your own. I hope I've shown you that you don't actually have to use the watercolour to paint every shape. You can just use very random watercolours in shapes. Let them all run into each other. And then just pick out a few basic shapes to show what it is that you're trying to paint. Find the image. Once this is fully dried, I'll rub out the pencil marks. You probably noticed that I didn't pencil in everything. I just penciled in some basic shapes. Nearly there, guys. Just a few little finishing off bits to show you. Need something a bit larger over here. So we just keep doodling until we feel we have enough. It is nice to leave some empty spaces. Showing just a bit of flow of the water around. I think there's a wave effect. Some stars to show we have night and day. The journey between the seasons. The garden is ever changing at Nan Tien. It's the most beautiful, beautiful spot to go and just find yourself. Temple is open every day except Mondays. Unfortunately, the temple's closed at the moment due to the mad COVID-19 virus that's going around. But hopefully through my artwork you will get a sense of peace and a sense of grounding. Love of nature. If you've been to the temple, you'll hopefully see something of the temple in my work. And if not, and you're traveling or living close by, please take the time to go and visit when it's safe to do so. And we might see each other there sometime. I love being there. I have lots of friends up there now. And I miss them. I miss the temple. And this is my tribute to my friends at Nan Tien Temple. Thanks for watching.